Welcome to 3ABN's Fall Camp Meeting, Homecoming 2015. Featuring inspired messages from your 3ABN family, along with uplifting Christian music, all to prepare your heart for the coming of the Lord.
Hello and welcome to 3ABN Fall Camp Meeting. We're so glad that you're all here, and those of you watching from around the world, thank you for your love and your prayers and financial support of 3ABN as we endeavor to take this great gospel of the kingdom into all the world. CA and Molly, you all happy tonight?
I am elated. I love camp meeting. How many of you enjoy coming to camp meeting? We always have so much fun around here. And, you know, we have already been praying that the Father, by the power of His Holy Spirit, will change every one of us. How many of you came wanting to have your heart changed? The scripture tells us, be not conformed to this world, but be transformed. I'm praying for transformation. How about you, CA?
Amen. Well, I think we ought to take up an offering. I think we just heard a sermon.
Okay.
I agree. Amen. All right.
we are beyond excited. Excited doesn't begin to tap into what God has infused with this ministry over the last several weeks. And our prayer is, our aim is during the next few days is to infect you with the virus that has infected us. We want you to go home sick and infected, and then we want you to infect others, because God has given us something. We're going to talk about it tonight. We're going to share it with you. Christ is coming soon, and we have been possessed, dare we say, of that spirit and understanding. And before this weekend is out, we want you to know precisely where God is taking us, because He's coming soon, and we want you all to join us as we go home together.
Yeah. Amen. Molly Sue, step up here a little. I'd like you to be right up front now. You're on television some, but rarely do you speak here at camp meeting. Are you? I'm not sure. I got in a little late. Are you preaching tonight?
Well, I might.
See why you love Molly Sue? Because she's ready in a minute here. She would, if we sit down, she would preach. Absolutely. Tell us what you're thinking today.
You know, we had a board meeting this morning, 3ABN's fall board meeting, and I just want y'all to know there is a word that keeps coming to me, and it's just expectant. There is just expectation, and it's just been infused in every one of us. I've been here now over 20 years. I was just a baby when I came.
We have to tell the truth now. Okay.
No matter how old he gets, I'm always older. And I just
think
that's a shame and a disgrace. There is so much.
She looks younger, though. I acknowledge that.
Okay. I'll settle for that. But there is just an expectancy around here. We know that God is moving in this end times. And the exciting part is we're a part of it. You know, I don't want to be back here on the back row, and I have never been one in church to want to sit on the front row. But in the end time move of God, I want to be right up front. How about y'all? Don't want to be back there somewhere. I want to be on the tip of the arrow that's piercing the forces of darkness and the power of the enemy and bringing the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ into this earth. That's what we want to do.
Preach it, preach it. You know what we're all excited about? Jesus is coming soon.
That's true. Amen.
Now, we've heard that for a lot of years. People say, well, how do you know it's not going to be another 100 years? As an evangelist once said, if it is, God will have to apologize to Sodom and Gomorrah.
That's right.
I mean, think about living. We've heard about prophecies all of our lives. We're living in them. I mean, can you imagine the Supreme Court decision to redefine who is man? The Lord is saying, where were you when I formed the worlds? Who are we to change and try to redefine marriage? Of course, we can't do it. But in the humanists, we do. And then on the White House, showing all the homosexual colors. I mean, that is something. Now, we're not saying we're down on gay and lesbian people, but we don't believe it's biblical. So we also should have a right. They have a right to say what they want to say, right? They're out. And so we should have the opportunity to say, you know what? We believe the Bible and the Bible only. Now, God's your, anybody's in that movement, God's their judge. We're not judging people. God does that. But it's our responsibility to tell people the truth. So we can't be quiet when these things are happening. What this is a wake-up call to you, to all of us. And I've said this before, Molly, but I see no difference. Some theologian can maybe give it to me. I see no difference between what's happening with the Supreme Court decision here in the United States of America than I see with the National Sunday Law. And we've heard about that all of our life, but God sanctified two things at creation, didn't he? What did he sanctify?
Sabbath and marriage.
Sabbath and marriage. And any time you trample any of God's laws, judgment's going to fall.
That's true.
Because what you've said is, God, we don't need you anymore. We're going to just rule ourselves. Now, all we got to do is look at the Bible and see that doesn't happen. We got a long several thousand years of history. When you push God out, what happens? Without God, there's no life. So what an opportunity that we don't have to talk about it anymore. Well, some years down the road, eventually this is going to happen and that's going to happen. It's happening right now. I mean, who would have ever thought we would live in a time? The Pope's here right now, right? Y'all, thank you for coming here instead of going to see the Pope. We're glad that you came here. He's got enough people following him. I think the world says all the world wandered after. But Pastor John Loma King is there. I think he's maybe on his way back. He's getting some video and some footage to keep us updated on what's happening around the world. And one of the new energies we're putting into 3ABN, we want to do some town hall type meetings so that every week or so we give updates on what's happening. Things are happening so fast we have to do it every week. So we're going to have these meetings where we literally can talk and discuss about present truth and events that are happening around the world that affect you and me.
That's right.
Satan is out to steal, kill, and to destroy. Mm-hmm. Jesus says, I'm come to give you life and give it more abundantly. And right now, the devil is out doing all he can do, so it's time. There's a war raging. Somebody say amen. I heard somebody. There's a war raging right now. There's a great controversy between good and evil. Am I telling the truth?
Yes.
And we're on one side or the other, whether we like it or not.
That's right.
You don't have a choice. Somebody said, nobody tell me what to do. Well, no. But whatever you are already, your decisions, we're either on one God's side or on the side of the devil. There isn't a purgatory, if anybody's thinking there is. I don't think that's biblical, is it, C.A.?
No, sir.
You're the
not.
Theologian. So we are excited to be alive in the closing moments of Earth's history and have a tool that literally is reaching around the world. And we're excited that these events are happening, and it gives us hope that Jesus could even come. As old as I am, Jesus could come. You know, Anyway, you get the point. I wasn't sure if I, you know, said something bad about it or not. But anyway, you get the point. As old as we are, we might get to live to see Jesus come. Isn't that exciting?
That is exciting. Huh. You know, in thinking about this, we've read the end of the book. Do we know how this is going to end? We've read the end of the book. Uh-huh. However, you know, and how many of you want the Lord to return? You know, we say this so often. We do. We want the Lord to return. But you know, there's a whole lot going to happen between now and then, and it's not going to be pleasant. But God has called an end time people, and we are that end time people. You know, those that will give their life and their hearts to this end time move of God, because it's an end time move of God, Danny.
Absolutely.
It's not just an end time move of
Absolutely.
The enemy. Yeah, he's rearing his ugly head.
Yeah.
But the kingdom of God suffereth violence, but what? The violent take it by force. How do we take it? By prayer and intercession on our knees. Every battle that's won, you know where it's won first? It's won on your knees in your prayer closet. So we've read the end of the book. We know how it's going to end, but it's up to us to be obedient to what God tells us to do.
I think it's time to lift another offering. She's done it again. You know what?
You notice the difference in the black and the white churches? We take up offerings, they lift offerings. You hear that? They all say, we lift offerings. Now, I'm not going to say any more to that. You think about it. We lift an offering. We just say, well, it's time to take up an offering. They're like, let's lift our offering right now.
Indeed.
I don't know what all that means, but I notice that difference, C.A.
Praise the Lord.
And I like the way you do it better.
The greatest thing in the world is being where God wants you to be.
That's true.
Doing what God wants you to do. And that's why you see this quiescent giddiness around 3ABN.
Okay.
It starts with Shelley Quinn and goes right down, even Brian. And treasurers are notably dour,
like,
sour, sober individuals.
More like undertakers.
Yeah, yes.
Sometimes they're more like undertakers.
But even
smiles.
Brian giggled his way through board meeting this morning.
Yeah.
It was a pleasure to see that face doing what he's doing right now. Because God has lighted.
That's right.
Yeah. Struck a match And we are all on fire for the Lord.
Yeah.
And we, like I said, we want that fire to hit critical mass and just go and go and go, because God has given us something that we believe, and I think Shelley was the first person to say it, that is going to usher in the latter rain of God.
Yes.
And when God does this, he does it in different areas. And so we want you to keep your eyes open, because God is starting something here that's going to crescendo. This is not the latest plan. This is not the latest scheme. This is not the latest mechanism of 3ABN. This is a move of God in the body of Christ, which is going to help finish the work. And Danny said this one, when you're broke and you don't have any money and everything is going bad, that's the time to go evangelize.
And that's why Brian was smiling this morning, because the coffers didn't look too good.
Yeah.
And I said, he's got the vision, because a treasure doesn't smile when there's not any money in the bank. But he's smiling because he's read the back of the book, right?
Yeah. We say this so many times. It looks like we like each other. And we do.
Oh, okay.
The rumors are true. We love each other, and we love God.
Right.
Amen?
Amen.
And when you got a love for Jesus and a love for your fellows, you cannot help but shine for Christ.
All right.
You cannot help but shine, and you cannot help but share what God has given you. We're a little selfish, because in Ezekiel, in Ecclesiastes, it says it twice.
Okay.
That if you see your brother going down, and you see your brother in error, and you say nothing, God says, I'm holding you accountable for them. So our enthusiasm is just a little bit selfish. We got enough sin in our own lives to deal with. We don't want to be guilty of yours. So we're telling you like God said, tell you, so that we can free ourselves of that little burden, and we can help you on the way to the kingdom too. It's a good thing to share Jesus Christ. And when you help others, guess what? You help yourself.
All you know, right. C.A. said we were infected. We're contagious.
Oh,
you hang out with
right.
us long enough, you're going to get what we got.
All right, I love it. One other thing that just occurred to me. Here we are living in the closing moments of Earth's history. So many things happen around our capital. I already told you about the colors over it. This week, the Pope is there. I was there Monday, and C.A. and Greg. And when would you think that while a Pope is visiting, all of these things, redefinition of marriage, and a Seventh-day Adventist running for President of the United States. Now, that's something we wouldn't have thought about in our wildest dreams, right? And so we are on the brink of eternity. But you know what? It's a beautiful world.
Amen.
Yes,
it's
it
a
is.
Beautiful world.
Yes, it is.
And I'm telling everybody, we ought to be able to say as Christians, it is a beautiful world. Right here in Benton, Illinois, just 8 miles down the road, if you go around the little town square, some of you going out to Walmart, look to your right and you see the old courthouse, and you see a hangman's platform and a hangman's noose coming down, where I think, I'm not sure when it was, 1929 or whatever, the last person that was hung around here that I know of anyway was a guy named Charlie Berger. And he was a gangster, he and the Shelton gang, sorry, but he and the Shelton, sorry to inform some of you that now, but Shelton gang, there's numbers of books written about the Southern Illinois Shelton gangs, brothers that did a lot of harm. They fought against each other, and it was all over during Prohibition days, and so all this fighting. But Charlie Berger got hung on the Benton Square as he went up, and this is what the people and all the accounts say. A guy's going to his death. He's a young man, I don't know, 30 or whatever. He climbs up the stairs. They're putting the noose around his neck. They say, you know, a lot of people go, tough guys go to pieces then, right? Tough guys go to pieces, especially if you're not giving your life to Jesus. But they say to him, you have any last words? You know what he said? It's a beautiful world. And I said, now if a guy that's getting ready to be hung and in 5 seconds or 10 is going to be dead can say it's a beautiful world, shame on us if we can't say that, right?
Amen.
Why is it beautiful? Because God created it. It's not everything that's in going on. It's ugly. There's sin going on. But it's a beautiful world because we're only here for a fleeting moment, and then it's eternity. Well, I had some kids join me, and this past year or so, I wrote a number of songs, and we did a brand new project. We had the CD out a few months ago, but I think we're just finishing it this last week. I brought some of the young folk here, and these songs, there's the CD and DVD for kids. All of them talk about the cross of Calvary. They give certain biblical beliefs that we embrace as Christians and Seventh-day Adventist Christians. And so we're actually going to show one of the videos that we have right now that the kids did just a few weeks ago here. And the title song is It's a Beautiful World.
It's a beautiful world that God made just for you and for me. He created it all in 6 days. I have faith to believe. The Bible tells the story of God's great power and glory. He made the light, the earth, and sea. He made the flowers and the buzzing bumblebees. It's a beautiful world that God made just for you and for me.
God created everything in just 6 days. On the first day, God created light. And on the second day, he made the heavenly skies. On the third day, he created the grass, the trees, and the plants. On the fourth day, he created the sun, the moon, and the stars. And on the fifth day, God created the fish and all the wonderful sea creatures in the water. And he created all the birds in the air.
It's a beautiful world that God made just for you and for me. He created it all in 6 days. I have faith to believe. And the buzzing bumblebee. It's a beautiful world that God made just for you and for me.
And on the sixth day, he created all the beautiful animal life on the earth. But he also created something very special that sixth day. Yes, special and dear to the heart of God. You guessed it. He created you and me.
Flowers and the buzzing bumblebees. It's a beautiful world that God made just for you and for me.
After creating everything in just 6 days, the Bible says that God rested. Let's read about it in Genesis 2, 1 through 3. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the host of them. And on the seventh day, God ended his work which he had made. And he rested on the seventh day from all his work which he had made. And God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, because that in it he had rested from all his work which God created and made.
It's a beautiful world that God made just for you and for me. He created it all in 6 days. I have faith to believe.
It's a beautiful world.
Such a beautiful world.
It's a beautiful world.
Indeed, it is a beautiful world, and I'll tell you, this is a wonderful music project. It's available now in both CD and DVD, and it is not only for the youth. We're finding that, you know, there's only one thing wrong with that song, and most of the songs that are on this, is that once you hear them, you find yourself running around the house. It stays in your mind, and I think that's how Danny knew he had some great songs that the Lord gave him, is because he'd play them for his grandkids, and he'd hear them running around singing. So it is a beautiful world, and as C.A. said, we love the Lord, we love each other, but I want you to know that we love you too. And we pray about that. We ask God. You know, Romans 5:5 says, He will pour His love into our hearts. And that's how we are enabled to love Him with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength, and love each other as ourselves. But I want you to know that if you are not concerned about the salvation of others, you need to have a heart check. Because if the love of God is in you, you are going to be concerned about others. And when Danny came and told me the very first time, he said, he's always saying, the blessing is on the go. But he said, we are going to start the blessing is on the go evangelistic team. And he said, this is how we're going to do it. And he started talking. I have not, and everybody can testify to this, my feet have not touched the ground since. This is, to me, I feel like everything that God has done in the past 31 years here at 3ABN was just to get the network in place so that this program could be launched. And I don't want to call it a program because it isn't a program or a project. This is a movement. And what we, the way we look at it is, it's just like we've got this fabric that's woven, and now God is going to come along and He's weaving you in. You can become part of the Go evangelistic team. The way in which it works is that if you give a monthly donation of any amount, you can become a Go Evangelistic team member, and we will send you a resource each month, a book or a CD or a Bible study, something that you can go share with your family and your friends and your neighbors. You will be supporting not only your local evangelism, but evangelism around the world. That's what 3ABN is all about. Our mission is to give present truth messages, to proclaim the three angels' messages. And not only that, but we need to be proclaiming the message of Revelation 18. Come out of her, Babylon. Babylon is fallen. And when Danny, when you were talking about end times, there's no doubt in my mind that Jesus is returning soon. Did you know this week they raised the flag of the Holy See at the United Nations? First time ever. What does that say? The Holy See is a political power. Revelation talks about this political power that is also a religious power. We're close. We're close. So I don't know how many of you are members of the Blessing on is on the Go team yet. When you sign up, we will send you a certificate. And it is signed by Danny. He's getting a little bit of writer's cramp because he's been signing these certificates. You also get a Blessing is on the Go book. And then you are officially part of our team. What I want to do, I'd like to call Jackie and Bruce Farley up. Molly, would you like to come up here for a moment? Because we have Jackie and Bruce Farley. They're like, oh. Yes, come on up.
You know, we were honored earlier, just a few weeks ago, to have a new chairman of the board Amen. Elected here at 3ABN. And Bruce Farley is the new chairman of the board of directors at 3ABN. And he and his family have been so supportive of 3ABN for many, many years. Merlin was on the board before. That's his father. And we have something now that we would like to present to Jackie and to Bruce. And that would be their Blessing is on the Go evangelistic team certificate.
And Jackie's sitting here saying, if I'd known you were going to do this, I could have gotten dressed up. That's not the way we work at 3ABN.
And what you receive when you first become a member of the Blessing is on the Go evangelistic team is, Shelley, would you like to give them their book? Now, the reason I have two plaques here is because Bruce, your mother, Joanne, has been a member of this team now for quite some time, and she hasn't received her certificate yet. So, Joanne, if you are watching, thank you so much for being a member of the team, and I'm going to give it to Jackie, and I'm sure she'll take good care of it and give it to you.
Thank you.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And I just want to say one more thing. As C.A. said, the reason I am so excited is I believe with all of my heart this is how the Lord is going to begin the latter rain, pouring out the latter rain. Because we can talk about evangelism, we can talk about revival, we can study and be among ourselves till the cows come home. And if we are not out sharing, we're dead. And I use this analogy. When we were in Israel, the Jordan River, at the source of the Jordan, is amazing. It's just, you can feel the ions in the air as it rushes, the river is rushing down, this living water, and it empties into the Sea of Galilee. Well, the Sea of Galilee is teeming with life. There's life and irrigation and farming, and there's just all this life around the Sea of Galilee. Why? Because the Sea of Galilee has an outlet, and the Jordan River then goes on from the Sea of Galilee to the Dead Sea. Why is the Dead Sea dead? Because there's no outlet. And if you simply receive the messages, but you don't share the messages, you're going to be like the Dead Sea. So what this program will enable you to do, if you're 9 to 90 years old, you can participate, because you can share each month this evangelistic tool with, if you're a stay-at-home person, if you have to have a caregiver, you can share it with your caregiver or with the mailman, or you can invite people over to watch it or to discuss it. This is a program that anyone can do. And not only will you be supporting and being growing yourself, but you're also helping 3ABN. We've got big plans for evangelistic series around the world, and it is going to be exciting, but the way I feel is we evangelize every day. So here's the deal. I'm going to be dogging you through the rest of the camp meeting. We've got a sign-up booth out here. And if you haven't signed up by the end, come see me. I'll talk you into it.
You can tell that she is so very, very excited. You know, when your spiritual batteries are running low, the way to recharge them is to work at helping someone else come to Jesus. It works on a personal level, and it also works on a corporate level. It works on a church level. I have found that in all of my churches, when people begin to pick at each other a little bit and get on each other's nerves and get cabin fever, the antidote for that is training your spiritual guns on the enemy and going out and stealing souls from his kingdom. Hal is saying amen, because you know that is true. When you want a spiritual boost in your own life, work for the salvation of somebody else. Lift up the name of Jesus, and in helping them, I guarantee you, you will be lifting up yourself. We have targeted a number of areas that the Lord has impressed Danny to look at around the world. There was a time when 3ABN was very steeped in world evangelism. We've got Julia Ukuna sitting there. That was a consequence of a meeting done in 1992. In the former Soviet Union. We've gone to Papua New Guinea, very large meetings. Well, God is impressing us to do that again. Do we have the wherewithal? No, we don't, but God does. And when God, what do you say, Molly? When God guides, he provides. When God leads, he gives you what you need. So we're not worried about that. We're just answering the call of God. On next month, we will be traveling over to London to just look at the possibilities of doing a big meeting there. And we want you to make that a matter of prayer. There is resistance there. And not so much from the church, but England is a tough place. Europe is a tough place. The work is not growing like it could or perhaps should there. But we believe that God wants to do a mighty work in Europe, like he wants to do it in Africa, like he wants to do it in North and South America, like he wants to do it all around the world. Our job is not to make souls or create Adventists. Our job is to lift up the name of Jesus and let the Holy Spirit do the rest. Because Christ has guaranteed, if I be lifted up, who will draw? I will draw. So our job is just to get going, because the blessing is on the go, and you will hear that over and over and over again this weekend, because we believe it in our heart. It's not just something that comes out of our mouths. It is something that emanates from our hearts. We believe that when you go for God, number one, God goes with you, Actually, he goes ahead of you and prepares the way, and then he goes behind you to get your back, to keep the devil off, and he walks beside you to give power to your words, so victory is guaranteed. So we want you to remember these initiatives in prayer. This go evangelism is not just something we say, it is something we are going to do by the grace and power of Jesus Christ. Let me ask you a question quickly. How many have ever had an experience in your life that you know came from the Lord? No doubt in your mind, you went through something and you know that was God's deliverance. And God gives you that to let you know that he's by your side. That's why we love him, because of all of the things he's done for us. When I think how Jesus loved me, how he waited patiently, even when I turned my back and walked away, when he knew I wanted everything this world could offer me. Well, I guess he knew the price I'd have to pay. So he watched me stumble downward, saw each compromise I made, heard each lie I whispered just to get my way. Still he waited there to hear me when I cried to him and prayed. Then he saved my soul, and that is why I say, tell me, is it any wonder that I love him? When you consider all he's done for me, is it any wonder that I long to do his will and let his light shine out for all to see? And is it any wonder that I praise him each time I think of how he's made me free? And is it any wonder that I've given him my heart when Jesus freely gave his life for me? When I think how Jesus loves me, how he watches patiently, how his arms are stretched to meet me when I run, when I'm feeling down and lonely, how he's there to comfort me. In the darkness, he becomes my morning sun. When I think of how he's healed me, how he's touched me in my pain, how his gentle hands have wiped my tears away. Now he's taken every heartache and brought happiness again. Oh, I want the world to hear me when I say, tell me, is it any wonder that I love him? When you consider all he's done for me, and is it any wonder that I long to do his will and let his light shine out for all to see? And is it any wonder
that I praise Him. Each time I think of how He's made me free. And is it any wonder that I've given Him my heart when Jesus freely gave His life for me?
Do you sense things are popping at 3ABN? It's kind of like the popcorn popper, you know, you use at home and accidentally put the lid off, you know, and that popcorn just goes everywhere. That's kind of what's happening here. One of the fun things about being at 3ABN, and also one of the challenging things about being at 3ABN, is when we get a vision, when God inspires us to do something, we don't think about the logistics, we just start doing it. And then work out the logistics afterwards. And that's been happening with the Blessing on the Go. So if some of you out there have not got your Blessing on the Go certificate, and you know you've signed up and have given for that, send us an email, call us. We're still working out all the bugs on the thing, and we'll be happy to get you your certificate and your first gift that you can use as a tool for witnessing. You know, in life, we're not always given joy and happiness. Sometimes sorrow and sadness come our way. Sometimes we're given a sack of lemons. But you know, God's in the business of taking a sack of lemons that life might have given you or I and turning that into lemonade. And that happened to us about 5 years ago. Something happened in our family that brought tragedy and sorrow to our life. But God took that thing and He brought a ministry out of it that's been one of the greatest blessings Diane and I have ever participated in, and I'm talking about prison ministry. Amen. And Danny has let me loose from being a bean counter at 3ABN, you know, the kind with the green eye shade sitting in a corner mumbling, you know. He's let me loose from that. He's given me a great assistant, is a young man named Davey Rodriguez. Davey is taking over the day-to-day accounting aspects, and Danny has let me loose to be involved or more involved in prison ministry. And I am so excited about it. We just have started the logistics of my move. I've got into my new office, but not settled. But I'm in there. I got my computer, and we're getting ready to launch out in some new areas in prison ministry. Amen. One of the things that prisoners have is something called time. They have a lot of time often, and they do have televisions in prisons, and there's a certain number of channels they get to watch. It's chosen for them, and we think 3ABN and its network of channels would be ideal for those guys to see. Don't you think so? And so we're working to do that. Just a few weeks ago, I was teaming up with Lemuel Christmas Behind Bars, and we went to Arkansas, to two prisons in Arkansas, giving gift bags. And one of them was a maximum security prison. And we went from dorm unit to dorm unit, sharing testimony, singing, and giving each of the guys a gift bag. They saved the to last two of the units that they call segregation units. And they warned us, these are the worst of the worst. I mean, we won't let you up to the doors of these guys' cells because you don't know what they might throw out at you. So just be prepared. They'll yell at you, they'll scream at you. And so we were prepared for the worst. But you know, as we went in there, and they had already given the gift bag through the slot into each of the cells, when we get in there and started sharing our testimony, you could hear a pin drop. They would clap for us, and they would shout words of encouragement. The guards were absolutely blown away at the reaction of what they considered the worst of the worst. Both of those prisons are interested in having 3ABN in those facilities as a result of that. God is opening doors. We look forward to your support. If you want to be involved in it, you can also, you know, you can send donations, but we'd also be happy to network with you and your churches to try to get something going in your area if you have a prison, or help you get started in a county jail ministry. Anyway, God is doing great things. There is a blessing on the go, friends, and we're about going. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, Brian.
Good evening.
We
are so excited to have you here to join us here for our camp meeting session. I always look forward to camp meeting because it's a time when our spirits also get watered. We're in ministry and we're always giving out, and it's so great at camp meeting time we can have our spirits watered as well. So it is a blessing to be here with you tonight. And I have with me my son slash assistant, Jason Bradley, and I am, of course, I'm Yvonne Lewis. I'm the general manager of 3ABN's Dare to Dream Urban Network. How many of you have watched Dare to Dream at least one time? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. That is great. Well, if you only knew that we have two people in that department, it is really something. And I have to tell you that the Lord is so faithful. He is so faithful. He has brought us programming and people to host the programs and all that. And he brought my son as my assistant. And I want to just ask him a couple of questions here. Jason, introduce yourself.
Well, I'm Jason Bradley. This is my mother slash boss. She's been my boss for 29 years now. So, not too much has changed there. It's great to be a part of a network that is reaching out and sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ to the world. You've been hearing about the blessing is on the go, and now we are actually witnessing prophecy being fulfilled. Mm-hmm. You can turn on the TV and see on the news that all these things that you've been reading about in the Bible are coming into fruition. My mother, she also always says to me, Jay, you got to get out there and share Jesus with everybody, because you wouldn't let somebody run into a burning building, would you? I was like, no. So you got to share Christ. You don't want anybody burning up. So we got to get out there. The blessing is on the go. And with Dare to Dream, we've been going to accompanying Brian Hamilton and Moses Primo Jr. Going to American Corrections Association convention, because those inmates need Jesus as well. It's for every living soul, every creature. We need to share the plan of salvation. And I'm so happy that Dare to Dream is incorporating all of those things.
Well, we're so happy that you are with us at 3ABN. You are a valuable employee, a valuable addition to our family. And it is truly a blessing to have him. Speaking of family, yesterday in our office, Julia, Helena, and Vadim came in. And Julia was translating for us. And one of the things that amazed me so much is the fact that God has told Helena to do the same programs, the same kinds of programs that he told me to do. And so around the world, God is telling us to give programs for men, programs on money management, a program on the sanctuary. She was telling me that she's doing a program on the sanctuary in 3ABN Russia, and I feel impressed to do the same thing, to do a program on the sanctuary. And so, Lord willing, we're going to do that for Dare to Dream. And Helena and I, even though we don't speak the same language, so to speak, we speak the same heavenly language, because we bonded. There was a bonding there. And I'm so thankful that God is using you, Helena, and that you are doing that work in Russia, and we are doing the same kinds of programs here. We know that we serve a mighty, powerful, faithful God. And so it is amazing. Next week, tell them what we're going to do next week, Jay.
We have some really exciting things in store. That's another great thing about Dare to Dream, is we offer practical tools for living and the gospel of Jesus Christ. Not only do you tell people about Jesus, but how can they live as a Christian? What types of things we are filming? We are going to produce a program called Working the Dream. How to bring Christ into the workplace. How do you carry yourselves? How do you have to operate with integrity? All these things that the community needs to hear. You'd be surprised at the people. I used to manage a restaurant prior to working here, and you'd be surprised at some of the people that you interview. And it's probably because they didn't have anybody teaching them. So it's important. We want to teach them the right way and God's way.
Yes, and we have another program coming up for men called Cutting Loose. And that program is also, it's based in a barber shop. And the barber shop in the black community is kind of where the guys go and hang out and talk politics and religion and relationships and all that. So we're going to be taping that one, Lord willing, at the end of October.
And this conversation at this barber shop will be from God's perspective, not the world's perspective.
That's right.
So it's going to be a lot better.
Thank you. I'm saying. To me, when you think about how awesome God is and how he loves us so much, you know, Pastor C.A. talked about our love for God, and it's, is it any wonder? And this song that I'm going to do really looks at God's love for each of us, for we are his one true love.
I am faithful, so I won't let you fall. You are my all in all, my everything. You're my everything, and you're special. I shed my blood to show that I won't let you go for anything, not anything, 'cause I reach down into the pit of hell to save you, and I forgot all of the sins that I forgave you, 'cause you are my one true given. And if you have faith, you'll see that you have been set free from everything, yes, everything, so you can smile again, for I have overcome. All of the work's been done. You're white as snow, you're white as snow, 'cause in my death there lives an absolute atonement. Tell me yes, and you'll be clean this very moment, 'cause you are one true love.
Beautiful, Yvonne. Beautiful. Wow. Y'all been blessed so far?
Amen.
Hey, we're just getting started. We got a few more minutes, and I'll know as soon as they put the clock back up, so I'll know how many minutes we got. But we're having a great time, and we got Elder John Carter is going to be here in a few minutes. And I'm looking forward to that. So we've got a few more minutes, and what I wanted to do, I was thinking about Jason. Jason was up here. Stand up a second, Jay. Now, he and his mother was at visiting one of the jails right here in Franklin County. If some of you haven't noticed, Franklin County is mostly white county, right? Jason goes into a jail, and he said, well, almost everybody in there was white. Well, there's a little boy that was in there. Five, six, seven, Jay?
Yeah, probably about five, six.
And this little boy was looking at you, little white boy, and what did he say?
Are you the president? I was like, no.
Hey, he looks like presidential stuff to me, doesn't he, you? All right. That's a good one. He's up here, and I'm trying to listen and be spiritual, and I'm thinking about what he told me yesterday. I said, now that is funny. This little kid, he didn't know. He said, hey, he looked so good, he thought you was the president. How about that? We have just a few minutes left. What we want to do, we're going to play one more song from the kids' CD. And I had never written a song. We've done a CD called Love Rules, and so we've got about 20 songs. And I said, there's very few songs that I've heard anybody write about lifestyle and diet and what you eat. So we came up with this little song that says, you are what you eat. And so we've got these kids that's going to be singing it for you right now. I think you'll enjoy their music.
You are what you eat, I've been told. If this is true, I plan to grow.
Let's take a look at what the Bible has to say about the foods we eat each day. Genesis tells about fruits, nuts, and grains. Leviticus tells us what else remains.
Let's read about it in Genesis 1:29. And God said, see, I have given you every herb that yields seed, which is on the face of all the earth, and every tree whose fruit yields seed. To you it shall be for food. The book of Leviticus describes the two categories of animal food, clean and unclean. God commands that his people only eat clean meat as described in Leviticus the 11th chapter.
No pig.
No catfish.
No mice.
No rabbit.
No shrimp.
No squirrel.
No oysters.
No dog or cat.
No snakes.
Let's take a look at what the Bible has to say about God's plan for us each day to be healthy and happy in every way. This is God's plan for us each day.
Boys and girls, we belong to Jesus, and because he loves us, he has given us great advice on how to be healthy and happy. Let's read 1 Corinthians 6:19 to 20. Or do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, whom you have from God, and you are not your own? You were bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's.
Now I know the truth's been told, and with God's help I plan to grow.
Aren't you glad that God has a plan for your life? 3 John 2 tells us what that plan is. Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in health, just as your soul prospers. Jeremiah confirms this plan in chapter 29:11. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. If you give your life to Jesus and take care of your body by exercising and eating the right kinds of food, then you too can sing.
Now I know the truth's been told, and with God's help I plan to grow.
And with God's help I plan to grow.
Amen. For those at home, they saw it, These screens are a little bit delayed for those of you in the audience, so I noticed the lips weren't quite with the, but they actually are with that. For those at home, they could see that, but for our audience, I thought I should let them know. Hey, we're having a great time here, aren't we?
Yes, we are, and the fun has just begun.
Yeah.
Pastor Carter will be up here in just a few minutes. How many of you are looking forward? Because he has an incredible message for us tonight, and again, it's one of those messages that's going to change us into his image and into his likeness.
Amen. The Word of God says that this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached where? In all the world, for a
witness
unto every nation, all nations, and then what's going to happen? Aren't you ready for the end to come?
Yes.
Ready for the end to come? Yes. Ellen White says, we have a part to play in the hastening of that end, in the finishing of that work. How many want to, at the beginning of this cabinet, because we're going to ask you again at the end, want a pledge to do all you can to hasten the coming of Christ in all the world?
Amen.
Amen. That means going to your next door neighbor, going to that relative that you hadn't talked to in a while.
Uh-oh.
Mm-hmm. Going to that person that may not have done you right and letting them know that you love them, but more than that, Jesus loves them. And being an agent of change for them. Let's close with just a short word of prayer. Father God, how we love you and praise you. And we call upon your Spirit to bless us here at the beginning of this camp meeting. We dedicate ourselves to you so that every word that is spoken will go into our hearts.
Yes, oh God.
Every thought will be on Jesus. Every song that is sung will lift us up towards heaven so that when we leave this place, we will take the power and presence of God with us.